taxpayers and the public in general consider well-maintained roads as one of the most visible uses of tax dollars. As a road maintainer, the work you do shapes the public's perception of how well an agency runs. So your skill as a motor grader operator not only shapes roads, but perceptions. People rely on you. You rely on your machine. With the techniques we'll show today, you can get more work done in less time. Maximize your grader's capabilities and be confident you're serving the public. If you're just starting out as a motor grader operator, be sure to first view Caterpillar tape number TEVN2947, H-Series Motor Grader Orientation. This videotape is organized in sections. That way you can study the entire tape or watch only what you're interested in today. So let's get started. The following demonstrations show normally accepted practices and techniques. Your techniques may require some modification, depending on soils and other conditions. Always remember to operate your machine in a safe manner, which includes performing a daily walk-around inspection and following practices outlined in the operation and maintenance manual. Make sure the machine, its attachments, and cutting edges have been properly maintained and that the tires are inflated to the proper air pressure. Be sure the side shift anchor or mount has been set in the proper bolt holes for your operating technique. Left holes are for right-hand reach, the right ones for left-hand reach. Consider three general operating rules. First, speed is critical for control and productivity. Select the proper gear for the application. Choose too low a gear and you'll sacrifice productivity. Choose too high a gear and it will become difficult to maintain accuracy. The sidewalls of the tires can become unstable and cause the machine to bounce excessively, creating a washboard effect on the road. Second, adjusting the moldboard angle can increase your productivity and fuel efficiency. Normally, a motor grader moves material across the area that's being graded, not straight ahead. It actually takes less horsepower if it rolls across and off the moldboard. When the moldboard is at right angles to the main frame, this is called a 0-degree angle. Angles of 20 to 30 degrees work well with light, free-flowing material. Use higher moldboard angles of 30 to 50 degrees in wet, cohesive material when ditching or moving large windrows. Most motor grader work is done with moldboard angles between 10 and 45 degrees. Third, using the appropriate moldboard tip can also increase productivity and actually help prevent damage to the motor grader. Generally, when cutting firm, compact surfaces, start with the moldboard tip or the top of the moldboard about 2 to 3 inches ahead of the cutting edge. This makes the material roll better along the moldboard without striking the circuit. As the tip is moved further ahead of the cutting edge, throat clearance increases and helps cast material forward rather than up into the circuit. These position changes help maintain better rolling action as material and cut depths vary. When processing out oversized rock or grading loose, heavy material, roll the mold board farther back so the top of the mold board is behind the cutting edge. Use caution in this position to help prevent material from striking the circuit. Maintaining gravel and dirt roads is still important in many areas and can be done efficiently because of the H-Series versatility. Typical maintenance activities include ditch building, ditch cleaning, backsloping, shoulder grading, roadway maintenance, and spreading borrow material. Keep in mind that establishing and maintaining drainage is the most important aspect of maintenance. Without a good crown and proper drainage, a road simply won't hold up. Keep ditches clean so they carry water away from the road. H-Series motor graders have increased reach with their link bar improvements and articulation, so they make this job easier even in deep ditches. To pull ditches or backslopes using the link bar, first check the side shift mount position. Then side shift the drawbar toward the ditch or slope and ground the mold board by putting both mold board levers in float. Then release the center pin with the toggle switch. When the light on the console is red, the pin is retracted. Pull the mold board levers out of float. Using both mold board lift and center shift levers, roll the linkage so the pin can be placed in the opposite side of the link bar that you intend to slope. If you're going to slope on the right, put the pin in the far left hole. Line up the pin hole using the marks and insert the pin. When the light goes out, the pin is in. Now, reposition the mold board. Side shift the drawbar to its maximum position. Circle the mold board and side shift it to obtain the desired mold board angle and desired reach into the ditch. Raise the heel of the mold board to match the ditch slope angle. Move the material up onto the road shoulder, placing it between the tandems or onto the ditch slope, depending on how much material you have to get out of the ditch. If the shoulder is compacted and stable, you can keep the frame straight as you position the grader on the shoulder. If the shoulders are soft, articulate so the heavier rear end of the machine will be offset from the shoulder. Articulation also helps keep the cab away from any edge of the road obstructions. Articulation can be used in another ditch cleaning technique. Crab steer and lean the wheels to allow one front wheel to run in the road ditch bottom and the other on the slope of the shoulder while you recover material that's been moved into the ditch by traffic or snow plowing. During this technique, the material will be placed between the tandems. This is cost effective since it lets you reclaim material rather than having to truck in borrow for road maintenance. Sometimes you may be required to completely rebuild a ditch. V-ditching is the most common type of drainage ditch. At 2 feet lower than the road, they efficiently carry water away from the road surface. Here's how to mark and cut a V-ditch. Keep the frame straight so the tandems track in the ditch. Tip the mold board so the top is about 2 inches ahead of the cutting edge. Set the toe, the leading edge of the mold board, in line with the outside edge of the tire in the ditch. Raise the heel. On the first or marking pass, have the mold board at almost 45 degrees to the frame. Lower the toe to make the shallow marking pass while in first or second gear. Lock the differential to help keep the machine in a straight line. If you're making a marking pass around a tight curve, do not lock the differential. Lean the top of the front wheels toward the heel of the mold board, just enough to counteract the side draft. On the second pass, put the wheels in the marking pass to help hold the machine in line. Keep the heel raised to increase the depth of the cut. Once you've established the ditch line, you can increase your speed and depth on succeeding passes. While you're building and cleaning ditches, you may have to dispose of sod and excess soil. We'll cover a few of the disposal methods. Depending on the width of the right-of-way, you can blade the sod over into a ravine or move it away from the road onto the backslope. Swing the moldboard into the high bank position to put the material on the backslope. Roll the moldboard forward and place the toe near the front tire so you can cast the material up on the slope and off the road. In this position, your view of the toe is restricted. Use caution so you don't puncture the tire with the moldboard. Cutting secondary ditches parallel to the main drainage ditch is another way to get rid of the excess sod. This technique gives you a place to put material, but it can compromise the stability of the shoulder if it is not well compacted. Water could settle in the secondary ditch instead of the primary one. Place the material from the secondary ditch up on the center line of the road. Then cut the sod and put it in the secondary ditch. Wet it and roll it several times. Finally, put the material you stockpiled on the center line back in on top of the sod mixture. You can create a narrow flat bottom ditch from a V-ditch. Start by cutting the V-ditch to the desired depth. Then put your grader right down in the V. Use the backslope to keep the front tires from sliding off the desired line. Move the center shift link bar one hole off-center, away from the ditch. Place the moldboard toe inside the front tire to the desired width and cut a secondary V-ditch about the same depth as the original. Cut the road shoulder slope angle you want and place the excess material up on the shoulder. Move the windrow to the center of the road and smooth the shoulder. Now, move the center shift lock pin two positions from the center toward the ditch. Put the machine in the crab mode. The tandems in the original ditch, one front tire in the secondary ditch, and the other one on the base of the shoulder. The toe of the mold board should be near the bottom of the backslope, and the heel position between the tandems at the desired ditch bottom width. Tip the mold board farther forward than usual. Cut out the center ridge between the two V's and place the material on the shoulder slope. Then, use the normal ditch cut position to get the material up off the slope and onto the shoulder of the road. Use a steep mold board angle to move the material up the slope in one or two passes. This helps prevent material from sliding back down into the ditch. Sometimes you'll want to quickly rough in a ditch line. Set it up this way. Shift the drawbar and circle toward the center line of the road. Straddle the ditch line. Keep the toe of the mold board even with the center line of the machine. You could cut deeper to an approximate depth, but you sacrifice some control of the slope and the bottom of the ditch because the tandems are running on uneven surfaces. You can get a lot of work done quickly cutting ditch backslopes with the proper combination of the motor grader's key features. Remember, always start with a smooth ditch and shoulder because any irregularities will be magnified at the leading edge of the mold board. Start by moving the center shift pin to the outermost position on the opposite side from the slope you're cutting. Now, side shift the circle and the mold board toward the ditch. Place the machine in the ditch with the heel near the outer edge of the rear tire. Adjust the toe of the mold board to give you the slope you want. Then, lean the wheel slightly to vary the depth of the cut across the entire width of the mold board without affecting the slope angle you've already set. You can also vary the depth of the cut by adjusting the tip angle of the mold board. Tip it forward for deeper cuts. Tip it back for a shallower cut. Material from the back slope will be deposited inside the rear tandem tires closest to the slope. Use a V-ditching technique to move this material out of the ditch. If the material is loose, use an even steeper moldboard angle and deposit the material partway up the shoulder slope so it doesn't fall back into the ditch. Then carry it up onto the shoulder with a second pass. Forming a high bank slope takes a different technique. This works well on slopes steeper than 2.5 to 1. Prepare the base surface so it's uniform and tilt slightly toward the slope. This will help hold the machine in place and form a neat line. Swing the mold board up and out in the backslope setup. Then position the grater at the base of the slope. Keep the frame straight. Move the mold board heel near the outer edge of the rear tire and adjust the toe to cut the desired slope. Make slow passes in first or second gear for maximum control of the cut. You'll be casting material inside of the tandems closest to the slope. Articulate when you're pulling slopes around corners to keep the rear tandems off the slope and hold the cut at the toe. You can extend the reach of the machine up the slope by articulating. Place one or both front tires on the slope and keep the back end down on the base. Lean the front tires away from the bank to improve stability in the articulated mode. You will compromise a bit of control of the finished slope in exchange for the extended reach in this position. When all the tires are running on a slope, keep the differential locked. This keeps the drive wheels from spinning. Operate in first or second gear. For finer control, use the accelerator rather than the hand throttle. Then, if you have to slow down, you can just lift your foot while your hands stay on the controls. On steep slopes, remember to shift the drawbar uphill toward the toe of the mold board and articulate with the heavier rear of the machine down the slope for a wider working platform and more stability. Deposit the windrow between the tandems. Use the windrow to help hold the machine on the slope. On slopes flatter than 2.5 to 1, start at the top. Cast the windrow material outside the lower rear tandems. Again, use the windrow itself to help keep the machine on the slope you're working. After you've established the backslope, you're ready to grade and clean the road shoulder. You can clean up the ditch shoulder with the machine either straight or articulated. Put the toe of the mold board at the center or inside edge of the front tire. Straddle the windrow. Shift the drawbar away from the ditch so you can carry a steeper mold board angle. The heel of the mold board goes outside the tandem tire. Lean the front wheels toward the heel of the mold board. Use a combination of steep mold board angles and medium blade loads so the front end doesn't pull down into the ditch. Attempting to pull too much material in one pass can cause control problems. To set a precise shoulder line and prevent material from spilling back into the ditch, use a steeper mold board angle and place the material between the tandems. Use articulation on shoulder cuts when you have to move large windrows that won't easily roll off the mold board. You can use three variations. Articulate the frame 15 to 20 degrees. Place the rear wheels in the ditch against the backslope and the front wheels on the shoulder straddling the windrow. The combination of speed, articulation, and steep mold board angles will allow you to move a large windrow in one pass. Or use the crab mode without the front wheel straddling the windrow. keep all the wheels up on the road and place the material outside the tandems. You can also use the same crab technique for smaller windrows near the shoulder. Reposition the link bar and use an extremely steep moldboard angle. Keep all the wheels up on the road and place the material between the tandems. You can make shoulder cuts of 3 to 6 feet wide on a hard surface road by placing the link bar in the extreme reach position. This link bar position is the only way to get this steep of a moldboard angle. Work with the direction of traffic so the moldboard is away from vehicles. Now, side shift the circle and the moldboard toward the shoulder. Position the moldboard horizontal to the ground and tip it about halfway forward. Keep the heel slightly above the pavement and at the edge of it so it doesn't gouge the surface. Position all three right tires just off the road edge to help compact material. Now, you can place the windrow just inside the rear tandem tire on the outer edge of the roadway, not on the main travel area. Be sure to note, too much speed during this operation may cast material onto the road surface. Use a steep moldboard angle when you move this material back onto the shoulder to keep any from running around the toe of the moldboard and onto the main road surface. If the road edge markers are painted and there are no other obstructions, you can float the toe of the moldboard to match the pavement and feather the material off the heel to the desired shoulder slope. Be careful using blade float if you're working on fresh asphalt or sun-softened material. You don't want to damage the mat. Now that the material has been pulled in from the shoulders, you can begin roadway maintenance. Proper crowns allow water to drain off the road. A crown is generally 1/4 to 1/2 inch rise per foot from the shoulder to the center of the road. For best results, dress the road when it is damp, after a rain, or when using a water wagon. You'll be able to process or mix the material effectively with adequate moisture. A major roadway problem develops at stop signs, on hills and turns, or wherever vehicles repeatedly brake or accelerate. It's called washboarding, that rippled effect on the road surface. To fix washboarding, you must either cut out the ripples down to their full depth with the moldboard, or, when the motor grader is equipped, use a scarifier. Keep the machine straight. Lower the teeth slowly into the ground and work in first or second gear. Then, reprocess the material and grade it back into place. Now you're ready to rebuild the crown. Start with the moldboard top about 2 inches ahead of the cutting edge. On straight or tangent sections of road, make enough passes to grade and place the windrow 2 feet over the crown. Then, on the next pass, the front tires will straddle the windrow. One front tire should be running right on or very close to the crown. Be careful. It's important to avoid straddling the centerline crown. When you do, you risk cutting off the crown and causing the center of the road to become flat. That shortens the road life. On the first pass away from the crown and toward the shoulder, be sure the toe of the moldboard does not undercut material you use to build up the crown. If you run short of material as you're rebuilding the crown, then pull up material from the opposite shoulder or ditch and spread it up to the center line. Once the crown is rebuilt, additional passes may be required to process, balance, and comb out oversized rocks or chunks of sod. When working on corners, the most important rules are: keep a consistent cross slope from shoulder to shoulder, and the cross slope becomes steeper as the curve becomes tighter. It's okay to straddle the center line in most corners since you're maintaining a super and not a crown. Be careful not to cut down the outside shoulder. That causes the super to become crowned. Often the outside shoulder needs to be built back up. The final pass across the roadway should feather out with little or no windrow to kick over the ditch slope. Many times you'll be spreading borrow material that trucks dump onto the road you're repairing. Your grader is the perfect tool for moving and spreading these piles. Make your work easier from the beginning. First, talk with the truck drivers and have them space their loads so material is neither concentrated nor spread out past the work limits. You are most efficient when you work alongside the piles. Don't waste horsepower driving through them. Instead, use the crab mode. You'll have better control and your front wheels will stay on a smooth surface. Articulate 15 to 18 degrees. This puts the tandems behind the load for better productivity. Move the mold board to an aggressive 30 to 40 degree mold board angle. Keep the differential locked to prevent tire spin. Cut a windrow from the piles that the grader can easily move and spread it evenly over the road. It's a good idea to work the material in both directions so you don't spread it too far one way. If you have to move the material straight ahead, keep the mold board nearly square with the mainframe, but shift it over toward the piles. Once you've spread the piles, you'll have to mix and process the new material. The H-Series motor graders are especially good for this task because they have a longer frame and can run steeper mold board angles. When you're processing large windrows, increase the mold board angle and use the crab mode to eliminate side draft. Articulate about 18 to 20 degrees. Start with a 30 to 45 degree mold board angle. Adjust it depending on the type of material and the moisture content. Run in third or fourth gear, about 4 to 6 miles per hour, but move only as much material as the machine will handle without lugging. Higher speeds may cause the machine to bounce and make ripples in the surface. Just as in other applications, you want the material to roll off the mold board. Too much material or the wrong tip of the mold board will cause material to strike the circle, clog the throat area, and lug the machine. Motor graders have the power and precision to do just about every road maintenance job. The public expects their roads to last and to be maintained. It's your job to make sure that happens. Practice your techniques. Think about the overall job. And operate safely. You and the public will be proud of your work.